Hello guys, assalamu alaikum. My name is Muhammad Ali and today we are going to be learning about sheets and workbooks. So let's get started. If I look at my workbook, it has two sheets, sheet 1 and sheet 2. For example, I want to put something in here. So I'll say that range even dot value is equal to how are you guys? Okay, so I'm gonna just run this. It appears in here, no problem in this. But if I go to sheet 2 and run this, still it will work. Okay, so the problem we have is that the problem is that macro works on the active sheet. So if I want to put something in A2, I have to be on A2 to put that thing. So basically the way to overcome this problem is working with sheets. So first of all, I can say that sheet one, that is the name of the sheet, dot activate. Okay, now what will happen if I am on sheet two, press F8, it will first go on sheet one, then change the value. But for example, if I don't have this value, now if I come back, come on, okay, so F8 again, it will, what will do, excuse me, let's first go to sheet 1 and then change the value. That is really an awesome way of going through sheets, but there are many ways to go to different sheet. For example, we have learned that you can say sheets.sheet1. Okay, sheet one. This is like directly sheet one dot activate. Directly, you don't have to type sheets. So if I like run this again, I go in here and then the value of that thing is changed. For example, this one is called greetings. Okay. So I can just type in this, okay, let me comment this out. I can type in here like sheets greetings dot activate. Now what happens if I go to A2 again and click this, run this, I'm gonna be on greetings. Okay, let's try again, run, I'm on greetings. Okay, so that is good, we don't have problem with that. For example, I want to change this tab's name. So how can I do that? Let's say activity dot name equals like today. Okay, if I run this, today, it has changed to today. Okay, now using VBA, how can we add a new sheet? The way to add a new sheet would be like sheets dot add. So using sheets dot add, we can also add a sheet. So as you can now see, we have added a sheet, but it's before this. How can we put it after this or after the end? So if I, for example, if I space, then I'll get the tips. Before, after, count and type. So if you want before the current sheet, so before active sheet, it will say that this active sheet, I want before this active sheet or after this active sheet. So I want in the last. Okay, for example, I'll say before, I want before sheet 2. I'm gonna say colon equals sheet 2. Okay, so if I play this, I get it after, before sheet 2, after. So what happens is that it comes after sheet 2. But if we don't know the value of the sheet and we want it in the end, for example, if I don't know that what will be the sheet in here, because if I keep on adding a sheet at the end, what will, for example, now if I say after sheet 2 and I play this, now it before sheet 5, so there is a problem. I want it in sequence. So how can I do that? Sheets.count. Okay. Now if I run this, I'll get sheet 7, sheet 8, sheet 9, sheet 10 in a, well, one after the other, means simultaneously. Okay, we have learned how to change the name of a sheet, but we didn't learn how to delete them. So how can we do that? Basically, you say that sheet value, like sheet 3, because I don't like where it is, so delete. Okay, so if I play, I'll get an error. Okay, oh sorry, alert saying, do you want to delete? We'll say, yeah, we want to delete. But then it's not like when you are programming, you don't want the viewer to see Visual Basic's error or Visual Basic alerts. So what you can do is, you can say first, like now we are on to, I want to now delete sheet 4 and 2. So I'll first go for 4, sheet 4. Okay, now I'm gonna say application dot display alerts equals false. So what we'll do, it won't let Excel display error. So let's play this. So directly sheet 4 is gone. Okay, if I go to sheet like 2 and play this, sheet 2 will also be gone. So the problem is, we have to turn it on back. When we turn off the alerts, we have to turn it on back. If you don't, the Excel won't let you, won't give you any alert if there is a problem. For example, you want to exit, it won't let you save it. It will like, come on, exit it. So you have to turn this back on. So every time a sheet is deleted, the display alert will be turned off. After that, it will be turned on back. So if we want to change the color of this, we can do so. Like if I go in here and say sheet 1 dot tab dot color equals VBA, right? So it says that it should be a red color. So if I play this, it will be in red. Now there comes our workbook. So if I want to add a new workbook, all I have to say is workbook dot add, workbooks dot add, and it will add a new workbook. Okay, you can see it's called book 2. Similarly, everything is similar to the way sheet works. See, if I want to delete a workbook, I can go and just delete the workbook. And there are many options you can work with. Actually, you can play with it. For example, I want to close this workbook, so I'm gonna say close. So of course I'll get some message or alert saying, do you want to save? But I don't want to do anything right now, so I didn't save. So thank you very much guys for this tutorial. If you want to follow along, so make sure to follow me on Twitter, on Facebook, on everywhere you can. And make sure to subscribe, comment, and do anything you want. So thank you guys, and see you later.